that. Those Mexican families were irate that they couldn't dig up those bodies. And there wasn't any mules in there. That was another myth, too. There wasn't any mules in there. And so there was almost a riot with the Mexican families that they needed to dig the bodies out, and they never could. They really didn't know exactly where they were at, okay? And here's another story. In this very office here, the doctor's office, there was a doctor that was poisoning young boys, and he poisoned 8. And in this very office, and he got away, the last one was sick, and he said, well, you know, I have to leave here because I can't take watching another one of these poor boys die. And he left, and guess what happened? The boy got better. And the boy also said that this doctor was looking for his gold, right? And he wouldn't give him the gold. And it is amazing how he left. And they tracked him to Wickenburg. And then he knew they were on his trail, so then he went to Prescott. And then he just disappeared. And nobody knows why, right? Nobody has any idea why. Probably to get their gold, right? So, 18 men, 13 men, 8 men died on these grounds, okay? Now, so you worked hard and you made money, right? And where did most of your money end up going? Right there. One of the amazing things, too, is you walk around, I don't know if you can catch it or not, all these ravens and crows that hang around the hanging tree. So, you worked hard. Where'd your money end up going?
Right there in the brothel.
Some things don't change in time, do they? Some things don't change. Now, I was in this very room here earlier, shooting some of my still shots, and right as clear as day. Now, in this room, I don't get any feelings in any other room in this entire complex. I haven't had any feelings. I get creepy feelings in this room right here. And not even in the bedroom, in this room right here. This is the room I get, and you can feel it. Man, woo! I got chills in here now. But I heard a voice in here say, hello. And I asked him to slam the door and move the door. And you can hear in the video, hopefully you'll hear it because it's not on a camera with sound. There is some sound, but it's not great sound. This door here is moving. Now, it could have been the wind. I'm not saying it wasn't. But man, you get it. I get a really creepy feeling in here. I'm not into creepy dolls either. You can keep your creepy dolls, okay? Whether that be in the Washaw Club or wherever, you can keep your creepy gloves. So with all the deaths that happened here in the Vulture Mine, I mean, if there was ever a place that was haunted, this would be it. And you know, one of the most amazing things is they have started mining again, which is awesome. I think that's just so cool that this place, you know, it lasted until 1942, right? And it's coming back. I think that's awesome. Now, also, hopefully you can see this picture here. Okay. Hopefully you can see that. That is right here. That was a tennis court. That is weird. That's a really extreme. That's bizarre to me, okay? Now, here's the bunkhouse here. The bunkhouse is pretty nice right now. It's pretty nice. But they say that it wasn't nice then. It was lice infected, maggots, and all kinds of fun stuff that you would expect to have with a bunch of, you know, dirty old miners. And conditions being with a tennis court outside their door, who would have thought, right? So here's the bunkhouse. I think it's safe to say that it's not period. And you know, you go in this room here and I don't get any vibe at all in here. None, zero. You know, I don't get any vibe in any of them other buildings. Even the assay office, I didn't get any vibes in. But that bordello, I absolutely got some crazy feelings. Now, one thing I want to look at is, man, they are doing it. They are doing a fabulous job at reconstructing this place. You know, at first I was like, it looked too good. But, you know, I looked at the construction and really it's just like they used to do it. And, you know, it really is kind of weird to me that, you know, they can construct stuff out of stone and mud and metal roofs that last 100 years. Now, we're going to go into the kitchen right now, okay? I'm guessing this right here was where they kept the food. And this would be like the pantry right here, is what I'm guessing it is, right in here. One thing else I want to show you also, we can go over and look at the tool shed over here if you'd like. They don't want you in here yet because they're not, haven't got it done yet, but I'll tell you what, they're doing a hell of a nice job. This is spectacular. Now, one thing that I find just really neat, to me it's fun, right? You know, there is the... Now, what I find amazing about that car is that it was made in England, right? So big deal, you might ask, you know, it was made in England. But what's amazing about that is, to me, is the company that started mining over here is an English company. So it's kind of funny that they've came back, you know, all these years and that car's there and then and they're there. So I just think that's fascinating.